Welcome to the introductory series on TI's solid-state relay portfolio. This video explains the basics of different solid-state relay products and technologies offered by Texas Instruments. We will discuss what exactly a solid-state relay is, existing isolated switch technologies, TI's technologies, and the types of products TI offers as well as their applications. Let's start by discussing what is a solid-state relay, or SSR. An SSR is a device that turns another switch on or off to control a load. SSRs have no moving parts and utilize an isolation barrier to separate a low-voltage system from a high-voltage system. This is often used to help protect the user against any danger from high voltages in the case of a device failure or short circuit. Galvanic isolation uses an electrical divide to inhibit unintentional current flow between two circuit domains. The barrier prevents unwanted DC and AC flow between two systems without compromising functionality and signal processing. This method helps to protect operators from high voltages. It also helps with reliability for signal sensing and communication where the high voltage portion does not damage the low voltage portion. TI offers solutions satisfying isolation standards such as UL1577 and VDE088417 to support customer and system needs. So, how does a solid state relay work? An SSR typically comprises of two main components, a controller and a switch or a FET. The controller's low voltage signal switches on and off a load. So, in the first case, when the control sends a low power signal to the switch, it closes the path between the source and the load, powering the load. In the second case, when the control does not send a signal to the switch, it keeps the path between the source and the load open, so the load does not get powered. Existing relay technologies include electromechanical relays and photorelays. A mechanical relay is an electrical switch that controls a load using a coil for isolation and metal plates for the electrical connection. Different power levels are available, including read relays, power relays, and contactors. A photorelay is a solid-state relay that uses an LED emitter to send light energy to a photovoltaic receiver that converts photons to electricity. This voltage then powers and turns on another switch such as a MOSFET. There is a barrier of either plastic or air between the signal sender and receiver. Both of these technologies use insulation material with dielectric strength of smaller magnitude compared to TI's isolation technology, requiring larger solutions to meet appropriate isolation standards. Electromechanical relays provide low resistance because of the metal-to-metal contact, but are subject to mechanical wear over time. While photorelays have better isolation technology than mechanical relays, they use LEDs that deteriorate over time from photo degradation. TI's isolation technologies include magnetic transformers and capacitive isolation. Magnetic transformer technologies use laminate or polyamide materials which allow switches to turn on and off in a matter of microseconds. Through capacitive isolation, silicon dioxide is used as an insulation material which is a proven, reliable isolation barrier with high dielectric strength, enabling low power consumption and small solution sizes. Although both of TI's technologies are high speed, magnetic transformer solutions are more compatible for high power transfer applications. Both solutions provide a wide temperature range for operation. Since TI solutions transmit both power and signal over a single isolation barrier, this can induce electromagnetic interference. However, there are many methodologies that can be used to mitigate this effect in sensitive systems such as Y capacitors, PCB stitching capacitors, ferrite beads, and chokes. Isolated switch drivers and isolated switches are the primary SSRs at TI. An isolated switch driver controls an external power FET. It generates its own secondary bias supply that is able to power external circuitry. It is best suited for high power functions and cases where switches are frequently turned on and off, causing significant power loss. Some FETs that can be controlled include MOSFETs, IGBTs, silicon carbide MOSFETs, and SCRs. An isolated switch is a single chip solution with an integrated FET and driver. It uses robust isolation technology and provides superior avalanche performance and small overall solution size. There are many types of SSRs that TI has to offer, including specific ones catered to either industrial or automotive applications. The TPSA 3050 and TPSA 3052 are SSRs with a basic 3K VRMS rating used for industrial applications. The TPSA 3050Q1 and TPSA 3052Q1 are automotive qualified devices with a higher isolation rating of 5K VRMS. The TPSA 2140Q1 is an automotive qualified isolated switch with a 3.75K VRMS isolation rating. When the TPSA 3050Q1 is powered, power is transferred across the isolation barrier and charges up the secondary capacitors. When the MCU sends a high enable signal from the primary side to the secondary side, VDRV drives the load up to 10 volts. Since the power from the primary side at pin VDDP is connected and used to power VDDH and VDDM to charge the capacitors, no additional isolated power supply is needed on the secondary side. Therefore, the TPSI 3050Q1 can also be used as an isolated power supply for other external circuitry by connection to either of the pins on the secondary side. The TPSI 3052Q1 operates similarly to the TPSI 3050Q1, except the gate drive voltage is 15 volts versus 10 volts, which is useful for higher power applications. When the TPSI 2140Q1 is powered and the MCU sends a high enable signal, the FET switches close, forming a path between the source and the load. The MOSFETs embedded in this system are avalanche rated, meaning they can endure high potential screening and up to 2 milliamps of current during avalanche condition. TI's SSRs are suited for many different automotive and industrial applications. In electric or hybrid electric vehicles, the high voltage car battery is just one piece of a complex circuit that connects to other important parts of the car, such as onboard chargers, traction inverters, DC link capacitors, and DC to DC converters. Three common applications of SSRs are pre-charging capacitors, insulation monitoring, and high voltage monitoring. The SSR switch drivers help pre-charge the DC link capacitor by slowly allowing current to reach the capacitor to power up the rest of the circuit, such as when a car is turned on. SSR switches help control measurement resistors used for isolation and insulation resistance checks for high-voltage battery terminals to monitor and maintain system components in a sufficient working condition. In these electric vehicle systems and industrial grid infrastructures like energy storage systems, it is important to insulate high-voltage terminals from protective earth to prevent injuries to operators. If you would like to learn more about solid-state relays, please visit ti.com/SSR. Thank you for watching TI's Precision Labs Solid State Relay Portfolio video.